2018 was a year of great movies, but there are some I feel got snubbed for Oscars they probably deserve. First, as a disclaimer, I will admit to having only seen about 11 movies from 2018, a pool that includes Black Panther, Game Night, Avengers Infinity War, Love, Simon, Incredibles 2, Ant-Man and the Wasp, Christopher Robin, Spider-Man Into the Spider-Verse, Venom, Outlaw King, and Aquaman, the last of which was cheesy but reasonably entertaining. Even so, here is the list of my personal Academy Award winners. For several reasons, the Game Night script comes out on top. It was funny, smart, clever, and peppered with several not-so-subtle jabs at the alt-right, which would earn any movie bonus points in my book. Credit also goes to John Francis Daley and Jonathan Goldstein for the rewrites. Based on the book Simon vs. the Homo Sapien Agenda, Love, Simon deserves Best Adapted Screenplay Award for being one of the most heartfelt movies of the year. The cast was superb and the story incredibly well written and executed perfectly on screen. Of course, between Incredibles 2 and Into the Spider-Verse, the latter will win. Visually stunning, amazing script, stellar acting, and above all, entertaining. There is really nothing bad you can say about Into the Spider-Verse. Many movies this year had awesome effects. Black Panther, Into the Spider-Verse, Ant-Man and the Wasp, and Christopher Robin included. But when you throw in Doctor Strange, Iron Man, Scarlet Witch, several Infinity Stones, Aliens, and of course, the infamous Disintegration, Avengers Infinity War wins out to be the best. Sure, I haven't heard the A Star Is Born soundtrack, but All the Stars carries the epic nature of the Black Panther film into the credits and into your earphones. I've literally never seen cinematography that was as cleverly done as Game Night. The way the camera made us feel like we were on a board game in the establishing shots, the car chases feeling like an arcade racing video game, and of course, the egg toss scene, shows extreme finesse with the camera and brilliant direction. There were some brilliant costumes in many movies this year, but Outlaw King wins my Best Costume Award for historical accuracy that makes you feel like you're really in Scotland in the 1300s. I suppose my decision may be influenced a little bit by being a big medieval geek, but... Many people viewed Thanos as a sympathetic villain, but I think Killmonger had a much more understanding, however misguided, motivation for his actions. And he wasn't entirely wrong, either. His argument was powerful even though his violent approach was wrong. Jordan really gave life and intensity to the character and really made us think. Another Black Panther alum, Gerrera shines as the unapologetically badass warrior Okoye, and she was funny while doing it. Her monumental performance only continued in Avengers Infinity War, and I can't wait to see more of her in future Marvel Cinematic Editions. As a connoisseur of Winnie the Pooh films, this film felt like a time portal back to childhood. McGregor fully encapsulated Christopher Robin's character while bringing him into adulthood and adding his own spin on it. You gotta give credit to Jim Cummings as well, and if there was a Best Acting Duo award, they would surely win it. When it comes to Best Female Actor of 2018, among my pool at least, there really is no other choice but Rachel McAdams. She was incredible as Annie Davis in every moment, from her darkly funny karaoke performance, balancing extreme competitiveness with a mostly down-to-earth nature, and who can forget that bullet removal scene? Game Night had a stellar cast, but McAdams steals the whole show from beginning to end. Let's be honest, there were a lot of brilliantly directed films this year, and some I still haven't seen. I mean, the Russo brothers managed to completely fool the world and totally blindside us with Infinity War, to the extent that I won't be surprised if both Iron Man and Captain America survive Endgame. But Daley and Goldstein captured a nearly perfect, brilliantly shot, clever, smart comedy that is rare in today's cinema. Game Night was seriously underrated and deserved way more attention than it got, but in my book, it's an instant classic. And finally, in a nominee pool that, for me, included Black Panther, Game Night, Outlaw King, and maybe even Into the Spider-Verse, Christopher Robin is a clear winner. Maybe it's nostalgia, but the movie was beautifully done and was truly a Winnie the Pooh movie. It managed to make me laugh and cry all at the same time and captured the spirit of both the books and several of the movie and TV adaptations. Disney sure knocked it out of the park with this one. Bring a bullet, bring a sword, bring a morgue, but you can't bring the truth to me. Fuck you and all your
patience. I don't even want your congratulations.